Division One players. So those kids aren't backing down, you know. And the other thing, a lot of times those kids you get like that from the city, they're not the best player. They're not the, you know, Trey Casey was not the most recruited player on his high school team, you know. So he comes in with a different perspective, which is good for us. But we sell them on what we do and how we play and show them how it's a good fit for them. You know, they can come and watch us play a game, or they can watch these games on on the TV, which is great for us, and say, can you picture yourself playing this way? Now, you know, and there's a lot of guys that are really good players that don't fit our system. You know, there's guys that are really good for North Alabama. We got guys that couldn't play for North Alabama. They got guys that can't play for us. We're both good. I think we're both really good teams, and we do it our way. And, you know, obviously Bobby has a lot of success. And, you know, now he does have a few guys I'd like to take with me, though, while I'm saying that.
Well, Coach Mike Niemeyer, we thank you for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow, your team tomorrow, 3:45 Central Time, playing for the GSC Championship. And good luck against whichever team wins this game.
Thanks a lot. It's just awesome to be here again.
Yes, sir. We'll take a break, and we'll get back to the basketball action. 47-33, number 3 seed North Alabama on top. You're watching the Raymond James 2014 Gulf South Conference Basketball Tournament Championships presented by CM Food Service.
To the end, it's just beginning. Life is getting lighter while the days are getting brighter, yeah. And it's a good, I won't even worry anymore. Took all my cares, took and kicked them all out the door. Go on and try, come and tell me what you're waiting for. Move and keep them going till your life is overflowing, yeah. I do a dance of victory. Cause now I'm living good, no, I'm not living like I used to be. Now talk about things, talk about my mind. Now I'm free from the words that I left behind. I gotta jump for joy and shout aloud and make a sound.
Everything life has to offer. Homewood, Alabama.
Let's check in with A.A. Moore with Coach Mike Helfer.
Tough first half there. They were getting a lot of baskets on the inside. What are you going to be able to do to kind of counter against that?
Just put my big guys back in. You know, I mean, they were out for most of the first half, so we were playing with the Mighty Mites. And, you know, I mean, they hurt us inside. They exploited it. So, you know, we didn't shoot it as well at the other end as we probably needed to counter that. But so we'll just get our big guys back in there and see what happens.
Good luck in the second half.
Thanks, A.A., and that's one way to get the inside game going is get the bigs back in there. 47-33, our halftime score. North Alabama with the lead. And again, if you're just joining us in our streaming coverage, we'd like to remind everybody tomorrow it'll be Delta State and the University of West Florida at 1 p.m. Central Time, playing for the Women's GSC Championship in the automatic bid to the NCAA Division II tournament. And Christian Brothers has advanced with their win against the top seed Delta State in our first game tonight. And of course, the winner of this game between Valdosta State and UNA will take on CBU tomorrow at approximately 3:45 Central Time in the championship game. Well, Coach, you were over there talking to John Carter, and A.A. was talking to Mike Helfer, and he said, Coach, you know, you got hurt inside. What are you going to do to adjust that? He said, put the bigs back in. He said, we can't play with the Mighty Mites against this team. But he did say, just like you did, they had to take better shots because they need to hit some shots. They just shot the ball terribly in the first half.
Well, they put up so many second because they have so many offensive rebounds that they've had so many second shots, and they're not finishing on them.
Right.
You know that, yeah. You and I can think of three or four series where they had three and four shots around the bucket and didn't finish. That plus some free throws would make a huge difference in this game. Devout North Alabama has made 16 free throws to Valdosta's 4. That's the difference in the score right there.
Well, the North Alabama team already out on the floor. They're kind of all together trying to get ready. You know, they're loose bunch too.
Most teams are reflections of their coach.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
I mean, Bobby just needs, once again, he just needs his pipe over there. Look at it.
All right, here we go in the second half. UNA with the lead and Valdosta State with the first possession.
And wow.
They try to go right inside, and Coach said we're going to get the bigs back in there. And, of course, one of those guys, Colin Cook, didn't he have 2 fouls in about
early.
15 seconds?
It was 3 minutes, yeah. At the 17 mark, he was down for the half.
Yep. There it goes into Cook now, and he draws the foul. Cook averages over 8 points and 5.5 rebounds and really hasn't been any kind of factor in this game at all. And he'll have 2 free throws, 61% on the season. And he kind of leaned forward with that one. Here's a look at that replay again, right into the big guy.
So he didn't protect the ball. He exposed it right out front. You got to rip it over the top.
And he made both the free throws, 43 degrees. We were talking to our friend John Carter. He says, hey, you ever get tired of watching free throws? I tell you, though, that thing has been helpful to a lot of teams. Great technology. Matter of fact, University of West Florida's women was a pretty good example of what that shooting touch. There's the long rifle, Wes Long. Must get that up and hit that 3.
So long. Yes. All he needs is just a crack.
Yep.
Good job.
Great job to get it inside. And that's David Murray. And it's a 13-point game. Oh, and Murray tried to anticipate and ran into Darrington pretty hard. That's the second foul on Murray. Long gets it down low. Bruce Adams got his own miss, and now he's going to go to the line.
I love the way Bruce works inside. he plays like he's mad at somebody.
Yeah, he does. And I noticed during when the team came back out, he didn't even warm up. I guess he just needed a little extra rest.
Maybe why he missed the whole goal
Could
right
be.
There.
I was
going
to say, maybe should have practiced a couple of threes.
Warm up might have been a good idea. Boy, what a bad pass.
Yep. Mm. Darrington in traffic. Well, that's more the range.
What a dish off. He threw it behind the defender's arm.
Didn't he? Mm. Well, Coach, I know we overuse this sometime, but these first few minutes could be crucial as to what response we're going to see from VCU. As you said, UNA plays at one speed, and that's fast. Crawford's going to leave. Stone checks in for the first time in the second half. Tyler Pritchard's going to bring it up against Stone. Darrington had it knocked away, and Stone came up with a loose ball. Then he was fouled.
He was messing with the wrong man.
Yep. Stone, of course, part of the Mighty Mites group that Coach Helfer was.
Yeah, he's the president.
Yes,
yeah.
He is.
He's mighty good.
He sure is. 15-point lead for UNA. Stone, the little runner, too strong. Claiborne up to get the rebound, and here come the Lions. Whoop, he was out of control that time.
Good.
Oh, that's a tough one. But it's going to be a two-shot foul.
Bailed him out again.
Yeah. What we need to do sometime is get one of those little GoPros and just lock it down on Coach Champagne over there on the sideline. It could be pretty entertaining.
It'd be on a delayed broadcast.
Yeah,
so with
probably so. Audio not included.
Audio not included.
And McKay hits the free throws. 52-39. Claiborne. Long. Spear.
Good gracious alive.
You'd love to have him at camp, wouldn't you?
No.
Little bit anxious. Up, and now he fouls. I mean, Jeremy McKay just kind of blew by him that time. Wow. We're going to see it right here.
Whack.
Little hack job.
Don't foul him. Foul him out at the free throw where he went by you.
Yep. And McKay hits the free throw. And Wes Long's going to go to the bench. As Calvin Dade checks back in for the Lions. And the lead is 11 now, 52-41. Darrington brings it on the dribble on the wing. Now Claiborne comes to get it. And he nearly lost it out of bounds. Fortunately for his team, it was touched last by the Blazers. Nathan Spear, feed inside, and as Bruce Adams goes up, he's going to go back to the free throw line. Boy, I tell you, when Adams gets it, he's going to do something to you to make you make a decision, right?
I mean, he stepped away down. He was kind of deep on that baseline.
Yeah.
I thought it was it's a poor angle to score from, but he's so athletic, he can fix it.
And the free throw is good.
A free throw workout.
Yep.
This will be his 10th free throw.
And this one comes up a little bit shy. Fall away that time. Blake
Tough.
Justice. Boy, they've missed
it. You know, Darrington did a good job of taking his first step away.
Yeah.
And he stepped back and hit a nice three.
Whoop. Thought that was coming to you.
Watch Stonehenge. He's talking to him.
Yeah, he is talking to him.
Nice.
Oh, that's a nice dribble drive. And that's Darrington. He took a spill after the basket. So numbers for Valdosta State momentarily. And
Gee
now the
whiz.
Little bouncing finish at the end. It's Jeremy McKay. And here comes VSU with a steal. Stone for three. Well, that would have been a big basket there.
Yeah, that would have been a timeout basket.
Yep,
right
it
there.
Sure would have. And now instead we have the media timeout under just under 15 minutes. North Alabama continues to lead it. They lead it by nine, 55-46. And we'll take a timeout and return to Homewood, Alabama after this.
O'Charley's throws down nine real meals for just $9.99. Like our new double crust chicken pot pie, overflowing like a taste volcano. Or our new Caroline chicken, looking mighty fine, Caroline. And saddle up, cowboy sirloin. Let's ride off into the savory sunset. Just $9.99, all day, every day. No gimmicks. That's the O'Charley's way. Or as we like to call it, the American way. The 9.99er, only at O'Charley's.
North Alabama with the lead over Valdosta State. Still plenty of time remaining. Once again, I want to recap, if you joined us a little late, Delta State in West Florida will play for the women's title tomorrow at 1 p.m. Central. Then at approximately 3:45 Central time here in Birmingham, it'll be CBU for the third straight year. And the winner of this game will take on the Bucks tomorrow for the GSE men's title in the automatic bid to the Division II NCAA championship. 55-46. There's a little runner. Too strong, and Valdosta State now brings it up on the attack. And Stone with a tough shot.
This will be interesting.
Yes, it will.
Okay.
On the wing, the three doesn't go. Spear goes in to get the rebound.
He took one quick three, and now he's got one. They don't even guard him. Wonder who McKee was guarding.
Bobby was telling him to move out, get some space. Whoops. He got the roll that time.
Made one.
And it's back to 11, 57-46.
Dr. V.
Yeah, Dr. V got the blocking foul. And Darrington's gonna go to the bench. Claiborne had a little rest. Now he's back in. Out of bounds on the play after the common foul. The Jets are now with three personal fouls. Good ball reversal in the corner. And a little pull up.
Nice.
Jeremy McKay.
They jump zone. Coach Helfer saw that, set his team in a set, overloaded, swung it quick, did a good job. Dr. V.
There he is. Up short.
It's the European intellect. They love to shoot it.
Boy, and I tell you, he's got some bumping going on right now with Colin Cook. And now they separate for a moment. Just watch the two big guys in the middle. This three again. Jeremy McKay, a couple of hoops in a row, and we got a 6-point game.
So long.
Less long, yep. That takes it right back up to nine. Wes Long, the senior out of Summertown, Tennessee. Crawford.
Wow.
Boy, when he makes his mind to go to the rim, you pretty much know it ahead of time, don't you? He is really aggressive.
So
long rifle again, in and out. There's going to be a rebound foul underneath.
You know, Wes Long only shoots it when he gets it.
You're right.
Just as quick as he can catch it and shoot it.
Yeah. And that's four personal fouls now. And I guess that was on Fuchetsa. But nonetheless, we got our media timeout at 11:50. UNA leads it by 9 over Valdosta State. 60-51, back to the Pete Hanna Center on the Samford University campus in a moment.
To compete for a championship in stadiums full with cheering fans and families. To give back, to say thank you for your support. To learn, grow, and prepare for the future. Ask any NCAA student athlete what they want, and this is what they'll tell you. Ask these student athletes, and they'll say with pride, I chose Division II.
Montgomery and Abigail Higgins had a tree that bore the most rare and magical fruit, which provided for their every financial need. One blinding blink of an eye, their tree had given its last. But with their Raymond James financial advisor, they had prepared for even the unthinkable. And they danced. See what a Raymond James advisor can do for you.
Both teams back out on the floor after the 12-minute timeout. We have 11:50 remaining. UNA leads it 60-51. Colin Cook will be at the free throw line. 61% on the year, so Noah will come into play here. I'm watching his free throws. That pretty good arc there, it looked like. And right on the number, 45 degrees. This one rattled around and came out. Eight-point game. Nathan's going to have to back off a little bit from taking it in against the big guys. And now Crawford scores at the other end. Now it's a six-point game. Straight away three in the net. Bruce Adams.
Well, we hadn't seen Bruce shoot many threes.
No,
that was
we haven't.
His first one of the night, so yeah. I wasn't sure that was the right selection, but I'm not sure that's something they talk about.
Right.
Nice pass.
Good dish off to the right side. Crawford too strong on the shot. Good ball movement. Claiborne back in there now, and somebody was grabbing him. You notice how their speed of the team slows down when Claiborne's not on the floor?
He is.
I mean, he controls the pace.
Quick.
Not that they don't get things done, mind you, but it just seems like it's at a much slower pace. Bruce Adams misses this three. Want to try to swing it, instead cross court the pass. And Blake Justice can't get the three. Well, you can just see he's not lifting with that ankle problem.
You're right.
Just doesn't have that good lift on the jump dot. Going to go out of bounds. It'll stay with UNA. Crawford goes out as Lester Moore, number four, back in for VSU. That little quick runner that doesn't go. And Stone gets it out to David Murray. Mike Helfler calls
2-3
out.
2-3 zone again for North Alabama. They're trying to see how they want to divide. They sent the point guard through to the corner, but there was already somebody there.
Six to shoot. Nice pass off.
Wow.
And Cook with the dunk.
Where you been, Cookie?
Yes. He's one of the bigs. He is the big for the most part. I mean, Murray's a great rebounder. But in terms of height, Cook at 6'8", the largest player. And he goes up to get the rebound here. 63-56. This could be a big one. Nope. Rebound Claiborne. And look at him blur. Whoop.
Yeah. Wow.
Got a little out of control. Now they want to settle it down a bit. Still 20 seconds on the shot clock. 63-56. Claiborne now with the right hand. ...65-56. Well, they still they're still in the zone there, aren't they, Coach?
Yep. Yes, and not big.
Stone stooped over it.
Big. Well, they needed that. They need, Valdosta needs a few stops.
Yeah, they do.
On the other end.
Yep.
They need to stop North a few times.
Yep. And, you know, Mike Helfer jumped off the bench, as a lot of coaches do, to call that timeout. And he bumped into one of the officials. And we got to kind of coordinate our traffic over here on the sideline. Yeah. Eight minutes and 2 seconds remaining, Coach. We got a long way to go in this one with anything could happen.
Still only shooting 36% by Austin, just not good enough.
Well, yeah, they're gonna have to improve that, that's for sure. 8 minutes and 2 seconds remaining. John Russell along with Steve Reeves and A.A. Moore. This is our fourth game today. And then now we're down to four teams, two men's teams and two women's teams tomorrow. ...65-59. Darrington outside, now they look down low. Oh, goodness gracious, better make sure everything's all right there. That was,
Did he take that fake?
Yeah, no question. I thought we had the UFC going at it here almost.
Here's that
for a
one
moment.
Trip timeout again.
Yep. Now we get the media timeout. 7:35 remaining. UNA's lead is 65-59. Hope you'll come back with us to the Pete Hanna Center here at Samford University in just a moment.
I was really looking for a school that not only had very high academic standards, but also authentically a Christ-centered school, and Union really stood out to me. After just spending a couple days here on campus, I knew that Union was definitely the place that I needed to be. Spend the extra time and actually come visit Union, and you'll really get a feel for what a Christ-centered higher education college is all about.
Why is he
We're
doing
back.
That? He does that all the time.
Yeah. There's some discussion going on among the officials. Now they're going to, I think it's going to be about maybe who's going to shoot the free throw, Coach. 7:35 remaining. Boy, that band is loud, isn't it? It's elevating. Huh? What?
Huh?
C'est moi. And Bobby Champagne over there talking with one of the officials, but the free throw is up and good. That's by Calvin Dade. And this one rolled off on 44 degrees. 66-59. Can Valdosta State repeat what they did earlier in the tournament, coming from behind late to win it in advance? Here's a three ball, rolls around, comes out, Cook lost it. Nope, somebody knocked it out of his hands.
Well, like you, I thought it was straight off of Cook's hands.
So they get a fresh 35 and a chance to reset here. It comes into Cook. McKay thought about it, now he backs it out. Straight away, Justice. Oh, and he just got, good thing he nearly turned it over. It's a shame, Blake Justice, you can tell he's not at 100%. This young man averages almost 14 points a game. He is their top three-point shooter, but he wasn't even sure if he'd even play. So I'm sure he's glad to be out there. He tries one here and rimmed it. Look at that rebound by Murray.
Nice play.
Yeah, it was.
Cut it to five.
66-61. Wes Long. And tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with North Alabama. Get it in the Long. Now Dade had it blocked out of bounds. Well, Dade is determined he's going to try to get a basket inside, and Valdosta State has defended him well. Comes outside to Adams. He's just holding it. Now he gets it in the hands of Darrington. Darrington tries to go, and he kicked it out of bounds. Five-point game, folks. 6:09 remaining. 66-61. North Alabama with the lead. The Blazers in the dark uniforms with the ball right now. Kick out to Murray. Yes.
2-point ball game.
66-64. We got another nail biter here on the men's side. Darrington. Oh,
gee,
what a shot.
Whiz,
high off the glass. And a 30-second timeout taken by Bobby Champagne. Hey, Bobby was giving that little, he's pushing there, buddy. Oh, what a show. 68-64, our score. Coach, I tell you, we couldn't have two better games than we've had tonight.
Wow.
That first one was a classic, though, I tell you.
I've been, once again, impressed with the heart and intensity of Valdosta.
Yeah.
They've come back.
And if you notice, Colin Cook has played most of the second half foul-free. That was after picking up two in the first couple of minutes.
And that's been a real factor.
Yep. Stone will bring it up.
David Murray, give him a nice combo inside. Yep. Look at here.
Alley-oop off the timeout. And slam down by Crawford. Boy, what a play out of the timeout.
You know, you set those plays up for more than just 2 points.
Why?
Look how he's jacked his team up.
Yep.
It has motivated them. North gets a little quiet on their end.
2-point game. And Darrington got the foul and the basket. I didn't think that had any chance to go in.
Me either.
I'm not sure that Marquell did.
What a tough shot.
And Darrington, a 75% free throw shooter, is going to go to the line to try to push that lead back to 5. And he does. Still 5 minutes and change remaining. Looks like we're going to have another close finish here in the Gulf South Conference. And a bump outside on the foul. That's going to be Darrington, the senior. One and one at the line now for Jeremy McKay. And he came up short. Boy, you got to have all those down the stretch, don't you, Steve?
Especially, it's almost being decided. Everything else statistically is even on both sides.
Yep.
It's going to be decided by free throws, looks like.
Darrington stops. Down low it goes to Dade. And somebody cleared out underneath. I don't know which way that's going to go. Oh, they're going to get Colin Cook. And that is going to be his fourth foul.
But he wasn't guilty.
Yep. Free throw short, though. Missed the one and one. 71-66.
It's time for Stoney to knock one down.
Well, he was thinking about it. Boy, this one's really deep. Oh, Murray. Jeez, oh, Pete. 71-69, a 2-point game. And a foul out on the floor as Calvin Dade was backing it in.
He's gone.
Yeah, and that's it. That's going to be it for Colin Cook. And look at Murray walking him over to the sideline and the bench. I know he's really upset, the senior. But we have the media timeout at 3:58, and we'll take it with you. 2-point game, North Alabama 71, Valdosta State 69. We'll be right back.
To the end, it's just beginning. Life is getting lighter while the days are getting brighter, yeah. And that's a good, I won't even worry anymore. Took all my cares, still can kick them all out the door. Go on and try, come and tell me what you're waiting for. Move and keep them going till your life is overflowing, yeah. I do a dance of victory, cause now I'm
Well, the intensity out on the court, in the stands, everybody involved in this one. Less than 4 minutes to go, 3:58 to be exact. And Steve Reeves, we got a 2-point game, my friend.
Boy, it happened so quick, too. North keeps going inside, but the little man factor has been a real difference this half. I think they've been hard to guard.
Calvin Dade at the line, and he short-armed it. Boy, didn't have a chance. And now Valdosta State can tie or take the lead. In a long time, I'm not sure they ever led in the game. If it was very early. And the runner.
Tough shot.
Jeremy McKay. 71 all. Claiborne hadn't touched it in a while, and he didn't get the bounce, but he draws the foul.
You know, it's the same thing you and I talk about so much. The defender is retreating.
Right.
He's backing up. The call is going to the offensive player. You got to square up and hold your ground. Don't expect the call to go any other way if you're retreating.
Rashawn Claiborne. And a free throw rims and comes out of there. Here's the last play. It's just exactly what you said, Coach. Not standing the ground there.
No, you got to hold your ground.
And Claiborne hits one out of two.
Oh, they've been so good on their free throws. They're, that's going to be crucial. That's going to win it.
Yep. 72-71, North Alabama, but not anymore.
Is that a two?
McKay with the three. And Valdosta State leads by two. Inside, there's our man. He hadn't touched it in a while.
They haven't given it
Bruce
to him
Adams.
In a long time.
Nope.
You're right.
And he needs to touch it. 74 all.
Double D.
Donovan almost lost it. Now he does. And contact outside as Darrington took it to the basket. That's four fouls now on Breon Dixon. And Valdosta State's going to take the timeout with 2:34 remaining.
Wow.
Coach, this has been something tonight, hasn't it?
Man. And this game is so fast right here.
We have had some entertaining basketball all week, but I don't know if it's been any better than these two men's games tonight. It's going to be almost hard, as you said, Coach, earlier, for CBU, for anybody to kind of regroup, because, you know, you're talking about less than 24 hours.
Exactly.
I mean, I know they're young kids, but it's the emotional part of it, isn't it?
It drains you.
Yeah.
It drains you. The only thing about it is both teams play a lot of people.
You're right. That's right.
When you check minutes, they won't have many of them that'll be in the 30s. Most of them will be in the 20s.
And a free throw good by Darrington. The UNA fans are on their feet back behind the Lions bench. Not many has made the trip from Valdosta.
Made them both.
He hit them both. 76-74. North Alabama with the lead. Valdosta State with a basketball. And here goes McKay. Yes, sir, that's a two.
They do a good job. When they find somebody hot, they keep getting it to
you. You're right. They feed the pig, don't they?
He walked.
Yeah, he did.
Walked. He hopped big time inside.
but he's going to go to the line.
Watch his feet here. Hop completely off the ground.
Now that's going to be the fifth foul on Breon Dixon. So he becomes the second Blazer to foul out in the game. With 2 minutes and change remaining. Blake Justice replaces him.
Mr. Murray's got to take over on that board now. They don't have anything but guards left.
Calvin Dade. And he hits the freebie there. Puts UNA back in front by one. Now it's a two-point lead. And the Lions bring in number five, Lonnie Smith. As Dade, only a 59% free throw shooter, despite the fact he hit those two. Bobby Champagne wants some ball handlers and some free throw shooters.
He wants some defense right now.
Yep, and defense.
They better guard. McKay's hit three in a row.
And he's looking for four, and he turned it over. Darrington. Claiborne, yes!
Tough, what a shot.
80-76. And a timeout taken by Mike Helfer. And it's going to be a full timeout. Stops the clock at a minute 39. Boy, Coach, what a basketball game we have seen
tonight.
Well,
they did just what we talking about. They went back to the hot hand. They tried to clear out for him at the top, but they gave great help defensively. And then when he tried that spin move, they picked him, and they did not hold it. They went to the bucket at the other end. And our man Claiborne just made another great drive to the bucket. I believe he could jump over that rim.
There's a replay on this last basket.
That's 20 points for him. Yep. He's been tremendous.
Yeah, he really has stepped forward as an all-conference performer tonight. No question about it. We're going to have to charge our batteries before tomorrow. I tell you, it's been a big night. We'll give it our best shot, won't we, buddy?
I promise. I promise. It'll be fun. Whichever team wins this one, it'll be a great final.
It really will be. 80-76, our score. McKay gets it back from Blake Justice, and he wants it. Look, didn't get it, but he's going to go to the line. But Jeremy McKay, wow, the senior out of Headland, Alabama, transfer from Sam Houston State, wants to see another day, doesn't he?
They went right back to him.
Yeah,
they cleared it out for him.
They sure did. And McKay hits the free throw. And missed this one. Went after his own rebound, but couldn't get it. Yep. Yep. Bobby Champagne says pull it out. Just over a minute remaining. 80-77.
Oh, my goodness.
Spear took a shot from three-point land.
And they got another clock.
Yeah.
Huge. Wonder why they call time.
I don't know. We're going to keep it here.
We'll find out, won't we?
Yep, we will. Yep. 56-6, 10 seconds remaining. What's going on in those huddles now, Coach? Got to try to keep everybody in tune as much as anything.
First thing you do, the thing I ask, why do they call a timeout? Because getting it in against pressure sometimes is one of the hardest things in the game to do. I look for Valdosta to really stick them defensively here and make the inbounds pass tough. Okay, they're bringing a shooter over the triple to get it to him.
And it's in the hands of the junior Nathan Spear. He's double teamed. Now they hand it off to Darrington. Outside to Spear.
Free throw shooters are in.
15 seconds on the shot clock.
And now they foul.
And Jones fouls. I'm not sure that's what Coach Helfer wanted there. He said, that's all right. Of course, it's going to be the double bonus.
And his perimeter guys are his best free throw guys for North Alabama.
91% free throw shooter. And it's perfect.
That four-point difference is big with 34 seconds.
46 degrees on our Noah basketball. Noah's arc, and he's money. He can shoot the freebies now. He hit nothing but nylon there. 5-point game, and here goes McKay. Didn't get the bounce, but he's going to go to the line.
And it didn't take him long to get to the other end.
No, it didn't.
Fouled and it saved a lot of clock.
Yep. And Jeremy McKay with 24 starts. He played in every game this year. And, you know, he's really carried most of the scoring load here in the second half, Steve.
Wes Long back in. Once again, he handles well, but particularly for his free throw shooting.
Yep. Long a 90% free throw shooter, so you want him on the floor. You're right.
If somebody else touches the ball right now, they need to foul him. And you see our man Stone here is trying his best to take Levin out. Don't let him touch it. Look at that swirl.
Looks like musical chairs, doesn't it? Up, and then it goes to Long, and they're going to foul Long in the backcourt. I thought they were going to stop the music and go for the chairs.
I don't know that I have ever seen that rotation there like that. Have you? Huh?
Maybe a few rodents in a cage. And Long will have two shots. Four-point game with 27 and 9/10 seconds remaining. Now it's a 5-point lead.
Now he comes back with a defender.
Yep.
They play an offense defense. It's good for them.
And here comes McKay in a hurry. Murray a three. No. And covered up quickly, and then the foul, Claiborne. Well, the Lions, 16 seconds away of not only getting to the championship game, Coach, but as you mentioned last night, if they hang on here, that'll give them 21 wins on the season.
Huge.
And that'll mean a lot when it comes to regional seedings, won't it?
Exactly. You never know what happens in the other leagues in this thing. Some of the people with a comparable record get beat out early.
Yep.
Then you say, who's playing best late? And North Alabama is very good late.
And how about Claiborne?
He's my pick.
Yeah.
I like him.
And there goes Stone, tip, no. Rebound North Alabama, and then the foul in the backcourt.
Ball game.
And the folks from Florence are having some fun. I tell you what. If you support your Lion basketball team, you ought to make that trip over from Florence, Alabama, over here to this game.
They need to get here tomorrow afternoon. They really do.
Because this team deserves it. Not that Valdosta State doesn't.
But and you know, we've talked about this before. In the month of February, probably nobody in this league played better than North Alabama.
That's
has.
Right.
They were almost 500 in the league, and all of a sudden, boom, great February.
Spear hits the free throw. And now it's a comfortable lead with 5 8/10 seconds remaining. A happy bunch of Lions. And once again, a gutty effort by Valdosta State.
Yes, they really played it.
They made that
run,
didn't they?
A lot of heart second half.
Yep. Here's Murray, he'll miss the dunk. And that'll do it. North Alabama will be in the championship game tomorrow afternoon as they'll take on Christian Brothers University for the GSC title and a trip to the NCAA Division II tournament. What a game tonight.
Boy, we've had two good ones.
What a night tonight.
I think we said this at the 5-minute mark, that the free throw is going to decide this thing.
Now you're right.
Down the stretch, North Alabama was really good.
Yeah. And a tough loss for Valdosta State, but Herb Reinhart, their athletic director, there to congratulate him, and he should. What a great job by the Blazers in the tournament.
Let me just say this, too. There are times when we don't quite understand Coach Champagne's substitutions, but they worked out great tonight. He knows his kids. He knows who he wants under there, and I thought he did a great job down the stretch of handling the run. The run by Valdosta was tough. I wasn't sure they were going to be able to handle it. They did. They did a great job.
And I think we're trying to get set up with A.A. Moore now and here with Bobby
Coach.
Champagne.
Had a big lead, saw it melt away, but your guys showed the veracity to be able to hang in there and pull this W out.
Yeah, Valdosta's a very good team and got a lot of weapons, and we knew they weren't going to quit, and they kept battling back. They made some big shots like they did last night or two nights ago against West Alabama. Our guys made some big plays with about 3 minutes to go. Made our free throws late. Senior stepped up for us.
Bruce, how does it feel, our player of the game? How does it feel after so many early disappointments now to be one win away from winning a GSC title?
I'm just happy everything came into place at the right time. That's it. We knew we had to click. Yeah. We knew we had to click, so I'm glad we clicked at the right time.
As that lead whittled away and actually you all fell behind, what was the feeling on that bench amongst your guys?
I don't think we was nervous. We were just trying to overcome adversity. We knew we was going to get down, so best thing for us to do is to stick together, and that's what we did.
Coach, you've had to battle through. Now you're one win away, like I was telling Bruce, from winning a championship. You've got a tough Christian Brothers team. Yeah, as you look at that matchup, what do you see for your guys going in?
I'm going to be honest with you. We gutted out both games against Christian Brothers, and they had every opportunity to win both of them, and we were very lucky to win both of them. They're playing at a high, high level right now, shooting the ball extremely well. We're going to have to play better than we did tonight. And really play on a lot of emotion. And I think the seniors will pull together and do that for us.
Big win for North Alabama. They're heading to the championship game against Christian Brothers. Back to the coach and Don.
Okay, thank you, A.A., and congratulations to the Lions. 22 points, 13 rebounds for Mr. Adams. A big night and a great night of basketball. Coach, final thought.
North Alabama got 32 points of their total off the free throw line.
Yep.
Dribble drive, they drew contact, they fouled two or three of the Valdosta kids out and were money from the line. And then down the stretch, like he said, those seniors were sharp and played with great pride. They wanted to get to a Sunday afternoon ball game.
Well, we'd like to thank our crew here with Jock Jive that's done a great job all week long with our streaming coverage. And we'd like to remind you tomorrow afternoon at 1 p.m. Central Time, Delta State and West Florida in the women's championship game in the GSC, and about 3:45 Central Time, Christian Brothers will take on UNA for the men's championship. That's all coming up tomorrow. You'll be able to see it on ESPN3, ESPN Watch, Watch ESPN, and of